Hello, and welcome to the Geek Primer. Listen to the following conversation.
When Captain America throws his mighty shield, all those who chose to oppose his shield must yield. They need led to a fight, and a duel is due, then the red and the white and the blue will come through when Captain America throws his mighty shield.
Any thoughts on what we can get Mum for Mother's Day?
What day is it? May 8th.
Civil War.
Oh, good idea. That documentary from the 90s about the American Civil War. I'll see if I can get it on DVD. She'll love that.
What are you on?
We're not talking about that Civil War.
We're talking about Captain America Civil War.
Oh, the movie.
And the comics. Yeah, but seriously. Usually we get it slippers, but I think she's still got last year's in the box.
I'm surprised they're only doing one Civil War movie.
I would have thought they'd need at least three to adequately capture the scope of the story.
It's the ultimate Marvel crossover event. Until the next one.
Plus, Cap and Iron Man duke it out.
That's just a totally superficial reading of an epic tale that looks at the meaning of freedom, government, power, authoritarianism, and what liberties people are willing to give up in the name of security.
Oh, yeah, right.
Then Cap and Iron Man duke it out.
Yeah!
Come on, guys. Do you want to give it flowers? Chocolates?
Hey. Who?
Mum, for Mother's Day.
Haven't we already decided that?
We're getting her Civil War.
Oh, do you think it'll include any of the Death of Cap storyline?
I'm torn on that idea. It would keep the movie in line with the comics.
But you're worried whether they'd make Bucky the new Cap or Skip to the Falcon.
But who will I look at if Chris Evans isn't around? Jeremy Renner? I think not.
So, wait, what are we giving her for Mother's Day? A ticket to the movie or the comics?
Well, if we take her to the movie, we'll probably have to buy her dinner too.
And if we get her the comics, we'll have to get her all 195 tie-in issues.
The movie comic.
Oh. Okay, we'll do the movie. But she won't understand it without the comics.
In the next few minutes, you'll learn not only how to understand this conversation, but how to participate in it. The conversation is about Captain America, Civil War.
We're talking about Captain America, Civil War.
Captain America Civil War is the sequel to 2014's Captain America Winter Soldier and 2011's Captain America The First Avenger. It is the 13th film in the Marvel Cinematic Universe and the first installment of Phase 3. The story deals with the government wanting more control over the Avengers, resulting in two opposing factions. One, led by Captain America, who wishes to operate without regulation, and the other, led by Iron Man, who supports government oversight. So whose side are you on? The guy who stands for freedom and liberty, or the dickish billionaire corporate head? Tough decision. The film also features the return of Black Widow, the Winter Soldier, The Falcon, Agent 13, War Machine, Hawkeye, The Vision, The Scarlet Witch, and Ant-Man, as well as including new characters, the Black Panther, and for the first time in an MCU film, Spider-Man. Welcome into the fold, Peter Parker. Now listen again.
We're talking about Captain America Civil War.
Oh, the movie!
And the comics.
Are you beginning to understand the conversation? The Civil War comic was a 2006-2007 Marvel Comics crossover that built on the events of previous crossovers. It follows the implementation and consequences of the Superhuman Registration Act, which requires the mandatory registration of any person based in the United States with superpowers. The act came as the result of the damage and death following the attack on Manhattan in Nick Fury's Secret War, the Hulk's rampage in Las Vegas, the aftermath of M-Day, and the time the New Warriors fought Nitro and destroyed several city blocks, killing 600 civilians. Gee, talk about your knee-jerk reactions. As in the film, Captain America and Iron Man led the two opposing sides. Iron Man, Mr. Fantastic, and Henry Pym argued that it was reasonable for heroes to have proper training and oversight, whilst Captain America, with Luke Cage and the Falcon, felt that heroes required secrecy in order to protect aspects of their normal lives. But what it really meant was superheroes punching each other out. Two versions of the Avengers were formed. The pro-registration team, with members such as Black Widow, She-Hulk, Ms. Marvel, Wonder Man, the Wasp, a clone of Thor, and Spider-Man, and the anti-registration Secret Avengers, with members such as Luke Cage, Black Panther, Falcon, Wolverine, Hercules, Goliath, and Spider-Man. Make up your mind, Parker. As with all events, the changes to the Marvel Universe were widespread. Until the next event. Let's continue.
I'm surprised they're only doing one Civil War movie. I would have thought they'd need at least three to adequately capture the scope of the story. It's the ultimate Marvel crossover event. Until the next one.
Crossover. Crossover. Civil War was a major crossover event, impacting all of Marvel's characters and titles. Crossover events began with characters from one title appearing in another title. But in the 1970s, major storylines such as the Kree-Skrull War, the Avengers-Defenders War, and the Thanos War began crossing into multiple titles, particularly if the storyline had war in the title. Then, in 1984, came the Secret Wars, and the start of crossover events which tied into most of the Marvel titles. In other words, a marketing bonanza. Crossover events then became a regular occurrence with the Secret Wars 2, Inferno, Extinction Agenda, Infinity War, Age of Apocalypse, House of M, Civil War, Secret Invasion, Siege, Spider Island, Avengers vs. X-Men, Age of Ultron, and Secret Wars 2015, which included tie-in titles for Infinity Gauntlet, Age of Apocalypse, Civil War, Inferno, Age of Ultron, House of M, Spider Island, Extinction Agenda, Siege, and Avengers vs. X-Men. 2016 brings Avengers Standoff, which crosses over many Avengers and S.H.I.E.L.D. titles as part of the 75th anniversary of Captain America. Apocalypse Wars, which crosses over many of the X-Men titles. And Civil War II. An event which can't just be riding on the coattails of the Civil War movie, can it? Oh, yes. Crossover events usually result in three things. Costume changes, the death of a character, and fans having to buy dozens or in some case hundreds of comics to follow the story. Let's continue.
Oh, do you think it'll include any of the Death of Cap storyline?
I'm torn on that idea. It would keep the movie in line with the comics.
But you're worried whether they'd make Bucky the new Cap or skip to the Falcon.
Captain America first appeared in March 1941. In Captain America Comics, Issue 1 for Timely Comics. Created by Joe Simon and Jack Kirby, the comic ran until 1950, by which time it had been retitled Captain America's Weird Tales. In 1953, Captain America returned as a backup character in Young Men, issue 24, now fighting communists, and his own comic was then revived for a further 3 issues, until September 1954. And that was the last scene of Captain America until March 1964, when in Avengers issue 4, Captain America from World War II was found encased in a block of ice and revived. No, really. Captain America is Steve Rogers. But is he the only Captain America? Well, according to current retcons, off and on. In order, Captain America has been Steve Rogers until his disappearance in 1945, followed by Isaiah Bradley, the lone survivor of a group of expendable African-American soldiers used as test subjects for the Super Soldier Serum, according to 2003 miniseries Truth, Red, White, and Black. Followed by the costumed hero Spirit of 76, who stepped into the star-spangled suit, according to August 1977's What If? Issue 4. Until his death in 1946, when he was replaced by another costumed hero, the Patriot. Thus explaining how there can be Captain America comics between Cap's disappearance in World War II and his revival in the Avengers in the 1960s. But the Patriot wasn't the communist-fighting Captain America of the 1950s. According to Captain America issue 155 in November 1972, the 1950s Cap was a schoolteacher who discovered a copy of the Super Soldier Serum, changed his name to Steve Rogers, and had plastic surgery done to become Captain America. Unfortunately, he skipped the part of the formula that's said to also use Vita Rays, so he ultimately went insane and had to be placed into suspended animation by the government. So Steve Rogers, when revived, became the only Captain America. Until 1974, when in Captain America issue 176, he grew disillusioned with the government and resigned, donning a new identity, the Nomad. Filling the void was Roscoe Simons, who donned the uniform in issue 181, only to be killed by the Red Skull 2 issues later. Steve Rogers then returned as Captain America. Until issue 332, in August 1987, when he resigned again, and a new government-sanctioned Captain America was appointed, John Walker, formerly the corporate-sponsored hero, the Super Patriot. Just what the government would want. Steve Rogers donned another new identity, the Captain, and Walker remained Captain America from issue 334 until he discovered his appointment and missions were all manipulated by the Red Skull, and Steve Rogers then returned as Captain America in 1989's issue 350. And Steve Rogers has been Captain America ever since. Well, aside from 1999's Captain America Sentinel of Liberty issue 9, where the Falcon, Sam Wilson, dons the costume after believing Steve Rogers to be dead. But of course, he wasn't dead. Until he died in Captain America Volume 5, Issue 25, in April 2007, following the Civil War. And Bucky Barnes, a.k.a. the Winter Soldier, became Captain America in Volume 5, Issue 34, in March 2008. By the way, spoiler. But Steve Rogers returned from the dead in Captain America Reborn in August 2009. Don't ask. But Steve Rogers didn't become Captain America again. Rather, he led the Secret Avengers, while Bucky Barnes continued as Captain America. Well, until Captain America issue 611. No. You're not imagining things. The numbering switch back. That's comic book numbering for you. Steve Rogers returned as Captain America in Volume 6, Issue 1, in September 2011. Until Volume 7, Issue 21, in August 2014, when he reverted to his proper age. And in Issue 25, The Falcon, Sam Wilson, took up the mantle of Captain America and is the current Cap. Until Steve Rogers comes back again at the end of the Avengers standoff event. It's all so simple, it could easily have been included in the movie. Now that you've heard the meaning behind many of the words and phrases used in the conversation, are you ready to contribute? Don't worry if you're not. To help out, try using this contributing phrase.
Happy Mother's Day, Mum.
Oh, boys, what a wonderful Mother's Day gift. This shield will help me kick your father's ass.
Yeah! Good luck, and be sure to check back again for more conversations in the Geek Primer. If you have a geek topic you'd like to be primed for, enter it into the comments. And please, feel free to subscribe. Goodbye.
Look out! What is it good for?
Absolutely! Listen to me! Oh, oh.